गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, इन दिस लेक्चर फोर्थ विल डिस्कस दैट हाउ वी कैन फाइंड द मोमेंट ऑफ इनर्शिया ऑफ अ रिजिड बॉडी विच इज रोटेटिंग अबाउट इट्स एक्सिस ऑफ रोटेशन. सो फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल कंसीडर अ रिजिड बॉडी विच इज रोटेटिंग अबाउट एनी एक्सिस ऑफ रोटेशन. देन फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल वट वी विल डू इज वी विल टेक अ स्मॉल एलिमेंट्री पोर्शन ऑफ दैट बॉडी. सो फर्स्ट स्टेप इज कंसीडर a small elementary portion of that body, and what will be the mass of this small elementary portion? Mass will also be small. So suppose the mass of elementary portion is dm. So consider a small elementary portion of mass dm of a rigid body. About axis of rotation, and this mass it will lie at some distance from the axis of rotation. So it lies at distance r from axis of rotation. So what will be the moment of inertia? As mass of the elementary portion is small, so its moment of inertia will also be small. It will be di. And what is the definition of moment of inertia? It is the product of mass into square of the distance from axis of rotation. So this moment of inertia of the small portion will be r square dm. So now what will be the moment of inertia of the whole body? Now the moment of inertia of the whole rigid body, it will be I. And how we will calculate it? By integrating the above moment of inertia of elementary portion. So it will be integration of r square dm. Now there are further cases that what is the type of that rigid body? Is the rigid body, it is like a three-dimensional body, or it is like a plane lamina? What is plane lamina? Plane lamina, it is a thin flat layer of the solid. It is actually a three-dimensional body, but it is in the shape of plane and having thick, very small thickness. So that is why it is known as plane lamina. And in this case, the whole mass of the body, it is supposed to be concentrated in that single plane. So now first case, if the rigid body, it is having uniform density, if the rigid body which you are considering to calculate the moment of inertia about axis of rotation, it is having uniform density rho, then what will be the volume of this elementary portion? It will be dv. Dv is the volume of elementary portion. Then how this moment of inertia, the expression of moment of inertia will change? We know that density, it is mass per unit volume. So dm will be rho dv. So here we will have rho r square dv. And if the rigid body, it is in the shape of plane lamina. If the rigid body is a plane lamina, what will be the moment of inertia in that case? Moment of inertia will be, here the mass is distributed over area. So surface density, it is denoted by sigma. So mass per unit area. Here dA will be the area of the elementary portion. So what will be the value of dm? It is sigma dA. So it will be sigma r square dA. So these are the expressions with the help of which we can find the moment of inertia of any rigid body which is rotating about axis of rotation. Now we'll discuss the rotational motion of a rigid body in the shape of plane lamina. Rotational motion of a rigid body in the shape of plane lamina. So here this is the shape of the plane lamina, a rigid body in the shape of plane lamina. You can see the thickness is very small here. Suppose O is the origin of the coordinate system and this is the rigid body in the shape of plane lamina which lies in XY plane. And it is rotating in XY plane but about Z axis. So, first of all we have considered a plane lamina or the rigid body in shape of plane lamina which lies in XY plane and it is rotating in XY plane. So if it lies in XY plane, it will rotate in that plane. But it will rotate about some axis. So it is rotating about OZ axis in XY plane about axis OZ or about Z axis with some angular velocity. So with angular velocity omega, with angular velocity omega, in which direction? This is anti-clockwise direction. So in anti-clockwise direction. Now we know that as every rigid body, it is composed of, it is made up of large number of particles having masses m1, m2, m3, mi, so on. So in the same way, consider that this body, it is made up of particles having masses m1, m2, m3 and so on up to mi. And each particle, it will have different distance from this axis of rotation. So if each point it lies at different distance from the axis of rotation, then their position vectors will also be different. Suppose this m1 lies at r1 vector distance, this lies at r2 distance, this lies at r3 and this will lie at ri, distance from the axis of rotation. And they will have some linear velocity also. And it suppose this is v1 vector, v2 vector, v3 vector and so on up to vi vector respectively. And they will have their different angular velocities omega 1, omega 2, omega 1 vector, omega 2 vector, omega 3 vector and omega I vector. But in our previous lecture we have proved that every particle inside the rigid body, it also rotates with same angular velocity as that of the whole body. It means all the omegas, omega 1, omega 2, omega 3, omega I, they are all are equal to omega. So the angular velocities of all these particles, it is omega. And what is the relation between angular velocity and linear velocity? In magnitude form, V is equal to R omega. But in vector form, it is the cross product of omega and R. So V is equal to omega cross R. But how can we study all these particles? The motion of all these particles about this axis of rotation, it is same. So what we will do? We will just study the motion of single particle about axis of rotation. And then from that single particle, from the angular momentum of a single particle, we will calculate the angular momentum of the whole body. So considering the ith particle, suppose this ith particle, it lies at point P inside the rigid body. And what is the distance of this ith particle in terms of position vector? It is Ri vector. and it will have some linear velocity, and we know that linear velocity is tangent to the path of rotational motion. So it will be in this direction. So what will be the relation between linear velocity of ith particle and angular velocity of ith particle? It is omega cross ri. So as this ith particle, it is also rotating about z axis. So it will have some angular momentum about that axis. So what will be the angular momentum? It is r cross p. Here we are considering ith particle. So ri cross pi. Pi is the linear momentum, which is the product of mass into velocity. So this will be ri cross mi vi. Mass is a scalar quantity. Now suppose this is equation 1, this is equation 2. Put this value of vi from equation 1 in equation 2. And what we will get? That this li vector, it is equal to ri cross mi omega cross ri. In electricity, in the previous semester, you have studied A cross phi B. This A and this B, these two are vectors and this is scalar. Then you can write this in this form. Phi, which is a scalar quantity, A cross B. So it is ri cross omega cross ri. Here we will use the formula for vector triple product. So suppose this equation is equation third. So using the formula of vector triple product A cross B cross C, it is equal to, first take B outside, we will have A dot C, minus then take C outside, we will have A dot B. Here we have A vector is equal to ri vector, B vector is equal to omega vector, and C vector is equal to ri vector. So this implies the angular momentum of the ith particle, it will be mi. Take omega outside, we will have ri dot ri, minus then take ri outside, we will have ri dot omega. This ri dot ri, a dot b, it is ab cos theta. Theta between ri and ri will be 0. Cos 0 is 1. So ri dot ri will be ri square. So li vector, it is equal to mi omega. Here we will have ri square minus ri. And this a dot b, this is equal to 0. Why ri dot omega is 0? Why ri dot omega is 0? Because a angle between ri and omega is 90 degree. Why? See this ri. This ri, it lies in xy plane. And the direction of omega is along z axis. It means z axis is perpendicular to xy plane. It means omega vector is perpendicular to ri vector. So what will be the angle between them? Angle between them is 90 degree. So if angle between them is 90 degree, it means cos 90, which is 0. Magnitude of this, magnitude of this, cos 90, which is 0. So ri dot omega will be 0. So here write the reason, because ri lies in xy plane. Omega lies in about z axis, and therefore ri, it is perpendicular to omega vector. So angle between them will be 90 degree. So this is the angular momentum of the ith particle, mi ri square omega vector. So what will be the angular momentum, total angular momentum of the body, of the whole rigid body in the shape of plane lamina? So total angular momentum of rigid body in the shape of plane lamina, suppose it is L vector, and it will be the summation of the angular momenta of all the particles, which is equal to this. So put this value here and you will get the total angular momentum of the body, which is summation I mi ri square omega vector. And what is this? MIRI square is the moment of inertia of the ith particle, and it's the summation over all the particles which will give you the moment of inertia of the whole body. So this is equal to moment of inertia of the whole body in the shape of plane lamina. So here we have L vector, it is equal to I omega. And this expression, it is analogous to this expression in linear motion, or you can say that translational motion. So from here we can conclude that the moment of inertia of the plane lamina plays the same role in rotational motion, plays the same role as that of mass in the translational motion. Now we will find the kinetic energy of the rotational motion of this plane lamina. So now the kinetic energy of rotational motion of plane lamina about OZ, which is the axis of rotation, it will be denoted by T. And it will be the summation of kinetic energy of ith particle. It is the kinetic energy of ith particle, and summation is taken over all the particles inside the plane lamina. So it will be summation I half mi vi square. And what is this vi in magnitude form? It is ri into omega, so it will be ri square omega square. And now you can rearrange this in this way, and this is the moment of inertia of the whole body. So the kinetic energy of the rotational motion of plane lamina about the axis of rotation, it is half I omega square. And what is the kinetic energy in translational motion? It is half mv square. Here this v is linear velocity, here in rotational motion omega is angular velocity, and I instead of I in translational motion we have mass. It means this half I omega square, again this moment of inertia in rotational motion, it plays the same role in rotational motion as the mass plays in translational motion. So from these two, from the expression of angular momentum of the plane lamina and from the expression of kinetic energy of plane lamina in rotational motion, it is clear that moment of inertia, it plays same role in rotational motion as mass plays in translational motion. So now from the rotational motion, or from the moment of inertia of the plane lamina about this axis, z axis, we can also calculate, or we can also prove the theorem of parallel axis. You all might have studied this theorem of parallel axis in year 10 plus 1 rotational motion, in the chapter of rotational motion. What is the theorem of parallel axis? According to this theorem of parallel axis, it is that suppose you have any rigid body of any shape, and this point is the center of mass. Suppose this point is the center of mass of the rigid body, and suppose there is some axis which is passing through its center of mass, and this body, it will rotate about this axis, it will have some moment of inertia about an axis which is passing through its center of mass, and suppose that moment of inertia is ICM, then suppose you are considering some another axis which is passing through the body, suppose through this point, then what will be the moment of inertia of this rigid body if it rotates about this axis? Suppose it is I. Now, if you know the value of moment of inertia of the body about an axis which is passing through its center of mass, and one more thing which you know is the distance between these two axes. The two axes, they must be parallel to each other. And if you know the perpendicular distance between these two axes, then you can automatically calculate the moment of inertia of the rigid body about this axis just by using the theorem of parallel axis. According to the theorem of parallel axis, it states that the moment of inertia of the rigid body about any axis, rotating about any axis, it will be equal to the sum of moment of inertia of the rigid body about an axis which is passing through its center of mass and the product of whole mass of the rigid body into square of the perpendicular distance between two axes. So this is the theorem of parallel axis, and we will prove this theorem of parallel axis from the rotational motion of plane lamina. So the article which we have performed in case of plane lamina, it is that this is plane lamina, it lies in xy plane and it is rotating in xy plane about z axis with angular velocity omega along z axis in anti-clockwise direction, and we have considered the ith particle having position vector ri and linear velocity, its linear velocity will be vi, and we have supposed that this point is P. Now consider the center of mass of this plane lamina to prove theorem of parallel axis. So suppose this point is the center of mass and this point is known as C, just as this point is termed as P. So suppose the position vector of this point is RC vector, and what is the distance of this point P from center of mass? Suppose it is RI dash vector. So here you can apply in triangle OPC, apply Triangle's law of vector addition. Apply Triangle's law of vector addition, and according to Triangle's law of vector addition, what you will get? That this RI vector, it is the resultant vector, it is equal to RC vector plus RI dash vector. And what is the moment of inertia of this plane lamina about axis OZ? What is the moment of inertia of this plane lamina about this axis, Z axis? We have just calculated in our previous article, it is I, and it is equal to summation I MI RI square. And we know that this RI square, you can write it as RI vector dot product with RI vector. and from this equation put here value. Put the value here and you will get I is equal to summation I mi. Here you will have RC plus RI dash dot product with RC plus RI dash. Open this dot product, open these brackets, and what you will get? Summation I mi RC dot product with RC, it will be RC square, plus dot product of RI dash with RI dash, it will be RI square, plus dot product of RC with RI dash and dot product of RI dash with RC. And we know that dot product is commutative, means A dot B is equal to B dot A. So we will have 2 RC dot RI dash. So now move this summation I mi inside the bracket, or you can say that open this bracket and you will get summation I mi RC square plus summation I mi RI square plus 2RC dot summation I mi RI dash. And what is RI dash? RI dash is the distance of different particles from center of mass. And this summation I mi RI dash, we have studied this in our previous semester where we have studied center of mass, that the sum of moments m1 r1 vector plus m2 r2 vector plus m3 r3 vector, it is equal to 0 when the axis it is passing through the center of mass. If the axis it passes through the center of mass, then, or you can say that if origin lies at the center of mass, or if the axis passes through the center of mass, then this m1 r1 plus m2 r2 plus m3 r3 and so on up to, it is equal to 0. So this quantity, the sum of moments about center of mass, it is equal to 0. And this summation I mi ri square, what is this? This is the moment of inertia of the whole body. And here we have ri dash. Here we have ri dash. So this is the moment of inertia of the whole body, which is the plane lamina, about an axis, because here the distance is distance of particles from the axis of rotation, which is passing through the center of mass. This is the distance of ith particle ri dash from center of mass. So this will be the moment of inertia of the ith particle about an axis which will pass through this center of mass. So this is ICM or IC. And what is this RC? So this proves the theorem of parallel axis. This summation IMI, it is the total mass of the plane lamina. So what we have got? I, it is the moment of inertia of the plane lamina about this z axis, and it is equal to mRC square. We have proved that this is equal to mRC square plus ICM. What is m? It is the mass of the whole rigid body. What is RC? It is the perpendicular distance between two parallel axes, plus this is the moment of inertia about center of mass. So from the rotational motion of the plane lamina as a rigid body, we can also calculate the theorem of parallel axis. So this is all about rotational motion of plane lamina.